Hey, what's going on, everybody? This is Mike at HiFiInsider.com. Today, I want to share with you my thoughts on the new AirPods Max. Let's talk about the two most controversial topics of this product. First is the price point. And then the second thing is they call it the smart case. Now, Apple is one of the few companies that I think have second level thinking in everything they do and everything they say. So anything that we can think of, any memes or any comments about the products, they have likely thought about it, analyzed it, and then made a decision to implement it or not. So the fact that the price is at $550, I think is very intentional. Now Apple makes a lot of premium products, very expensive things, especially the first generation. Going back to the iPhone, the original iPhone was $600 for an 8 gigabyte version. And that was, everyone said, no one would buy a $600 phone. That's just crazy. And then they came out with the iPad. That was also very expensive. Everyone said that it was an oversized iPhone. It's going to fail. More recent time that we can think of is the XDR display, a $6,000 monitor. And then we have the AirPods in 2016. Everyone said they look stupid and that they are not going to sell. And look what we have now in 2020, right? AirPods are commanding a big chunk of the market. I think the last time I read it was over 60% of the wireless headphones market. So the AirPods Max at $550, a product that's very expensive for the average person, but not overly expensive for the Apple fan. Price, I think, is likely going to come down either through third-party sellers or from Apple themselves when they release a second-generation model, or maybe even a sports model, right? They're not going to say that it's going to be a cheaper material model, but it's going to probably be lesser in manufacturing costs, and then they'll name it like a sports version or a light version or whatever, and they'll reduce the price. And then even if they were to sell that at $400 compared to the $550, $400 seems to be very, very cheap, and then everyone's going to jump on it because they know the AirPods brand, the AirPods Max, sound great. So I think the price is intentional. Is it overpriced? I don't think so. I think people need to stop saying it's overpriced, because overpriced actually means that you can get the same item at a lower price somewhere else. So I'll give an example. When you're on an airplane and you want to buy a pack of candy, if it's like $2 for a pack of candy versus 25 cents or less, at the grocery store, right? You can get four for a dollar. That's overpriced. Let's talk about the case now. Again, Apple has second level thinking. They thought of what the people would say about the case. They made a decision to implement it. Now, do I like the design of the case? I'm not a fan of it, but I don't hate it. I certainly don't recommend the white one for a lot of people because I know that this is going to get dirty or get marks on it if you travel around with it. They don't want you to use the case. They want you to wear the headphone, on your head or around your neck. And that's why they fold flat rather than folding inward like the Sony does. Another thing about the Max case, people complain about that the lightning port doesn't line up with the opening slot of the case. Well, that's because the headphone is expanded. If you retract the headphone, the lightning port will line up. People said that the smart case doesn't turn off the headphone, and they think that it's very stupid because if you're going to carry the case, you want the headphone to preserve the battery. Now, that's a very short-sighted view of the smart case, in my opinion. Apple has this app called Find My, which you can find my friends or find my devices like the Mac or iPhone, iPad, and AirPods. Now, if the AirPods are turned off, you're not going to be able to find it. Right. So if you say, for example, you're at the coffee shop, right, you put the headphones in the case and the case turns the headphone off and you walk away from the counter because you were busy with your coffee or something, and then you can't find your Macs. because they're off. Do you find my app is going to be useless for you, and you're going to yell at Apple, like, well, this app is stupid because it's useless. I can't find my Macs because it's turned off. Apple is one of those companies that they want you to use the product. They don't want you to think about how the tech works. They just want it to work. And keeping the headphones on and connected on your, to your phone when you're not using it allows you to pull it out of the case and immediately it connects to your device and you can start playing music. You don't have to go into the Bluetooth settings. You don't have to hit connect anymore because that's what the problem people had in the past with, you know, the older Bluetooth headphones. And I think that once people are used to the convenience of auto switching, the magic of switching from devices to devices, as long as you're within the Apple ecosystem, you're used to that. Once you're used to that, any other headphones that doesn't do it, you're going to kick and scream about how dumb those headphones are. Right now, we are not accustomed to those features yet, but I think in a year or two, we are going to be spoiled by it, and we're not even going to think about it because we expect it to happen, just like we don't think about our refrigerators, right? We expect it to work, and we expect it to keep things cold. I really like the digital crown. I think it allows me to have a fine-tuned level listening, much more fine than the buttons on my iPhone. I do wish that I could flip the headphone around to make it, you know, on the left side instead of my right side. You are not right-handed, or you don't have a right hand at all, right? Then you can change the setting to flip the headphone around. And I think that Apple can probably do this in software. Now, I don't think it's going to be a main feature that if they do this, because the buttons are on a different location. If you flip the headphone around, now the digital crown is going to be in the front, and the button is in the back. And even if you flip the ear pads around and cover the proximity sensor, it still works. I've tried it already. It still works. So Apple can easily implement this, and I hope they do for those who want to use the controls on the left side. Now, I really like that the controls are hard buttons and not the swipey things that some headphone manufacturers are doing, because the swipey things just don't work well. It's just terrible because when you're not looking at something and you try to touch it, you're going to try to feel for it first, and then it's going to trigger the things that you don't want it to do. In addition to that, because these cups are aluminum, when you're rubbing against it, it actually amplifies that rubbing sound to the inside of the headphone. You can hear it quite loudly. It sounds like sandpaper. It sounds like rubbing on sandpaper. And if you have AirPods on right now, you give that a try. It's not a very pleasant sound. And I'm glad that Apple has tested that and decided not to do that feature. The Max's wireless capabilities is actually very good. Very strong wireless connection. I can move around the entire house without any dropout. The thing I love about the AirPods is that you can use them when it's charging. So if the batteries are immensely low, you need to charge it up, plug it in, and you can still use them wirelessly. I also like that you can share whatever you're listening with another pair of headphones, and that's something that Apple has implemented very, very well. I've tried Android, I've tried Windows, those are completely garbage. Apple is the only one that can do it very well because of the H1 chip, and also very low latency. So when you're sharing an iPad and watching a movie, both of you are hearing the same thing, and the latency is very, very low. Now, using the cable, people complain about the cable being expensive. I actually don't think it's very expensive. I think it's a very well-made cable. It's a digital to analog cable. This cable is very thin, I give you that, but there's a reason for that why it's so thin. Because when the cable is rubbing against your body or your clothing, you don't want that cable to be heavy and microphonic, meaning that you'll be able to hear the rubbing of the sound through the headphones. So the lighter the weight, the lighter the cable, the thinner it is, the less of that experience that you'll have. and Apple has really probably made it the thinnest they can possibly make this cable while still making the cable a good quality one. The cable jack itself is a stereo jack, so it's not a TRRS jack, meaning there's no microphone on this cable, so it's pure analog. So when you're connected to your computer or your phone or your iPad, it does not use the microphone on the Macs. It will use the microphone on that device. I think primarily this is because of latency. They don't want you to make a selfie video where your talking doesn't line up with the video. If latency is a important thing for you, like you use your headphones to edit videos, or you're a DJ, you need low latency, you'll need to buy the wire. I think the build quality of the Macs is very, very good. But I do have some concerns, is the mesh headband. Now, it does have good tension to support your head right now because it's brand new, but I don't know how this will hold up in a couple of years. Will it start to sag? Right? Apple said this is a very strong mesh, and that's why it doesn't need protection, but can you poke a hole through it? We will find out in a few years when people post their pictures on Twitter complaining about that. But so far, I haven't heard about it yet. I think that a little bit of an oversight, I'm not sure if it's really an oversight or is intentional. It's that when you take them out of the case, they bang against each other. Now, it could be that these are in very durable anodization, very durable aluminum, where it's not going to scratch at all, no matter how you bang it against each other. But I think the idea of it banging against each other certainly is not very comforting. But something that we will find out as this thing age. So let's talk about the sound. I think the sound quality is very good. The sound signature is not offensive at all. There's no peaks or spikes in the frequencies. It doesn't sound too boomy. It does get loud enough, but it doesn't get so loud that you're not going to be able to withstand the volume. I think they intentionally do this to limit your exposure to high listening levels. I also noticed that when wired mode, it has the same volume as wireless mode. And I talked a little bit about the computational audio in a separate video, and I think you guys should check that out. So playing a CD quality track that has a lot of dynamic range, there's very little compression in this track. Max performed really, really good. It gave me that hit, the dynamic range that a high-end headphone delivers. The sound is on the warmer side of things, but it's not too rich or too lush where everything sounds like it's in slow motion. And the treble has no peaks or spikes in it where it sounds sibilant in any way. The bass is phenomenal. Certainly if you're a bass head, you'll also find these to be very enjoyable. When I use the Macs in wired mode with my high resolution music player, this $3,200 Sony Walkman, the sound quality is actually really, really good. I think if you want to maximize the performance of the Macs, definitely use it with a high-end music player. If you truly care about the best sound quality, use the Macs in wired mode. Using the Macs with my AK Alpha Con player, even in line out mode, I set it to 2V. For some reason, the Alpha Con was able to clip the signal of the AirPods Max, causing distortion in the sound. So I have to check with AK on this and figure out why it's doing that, because it's not doing that on my Sony. So on my Sony, I set it to maximum output and then control the listening level on the digital crown on the Max. And I was able to get a very good sound quality out of it. Should you buy the Macs? I think if you're watching this video, it's likely that you can afford to buy the Macs. And I think that if you value all the convenience, all the features, the build quality of the Macs, I think these are worth owning. I own 2 pairs. I love them. I think they are underpriced for what you get, and I highly recommend them. Now, if you want to support this channel, please use my Amazon link below to get the best price, and then you also support the channel because we don't have any advertisers here. Thanks for watching my videos. I really appreciate it, and I'll see you guys again in my next one. Bye-bye.